Hey yo, Nerdcore Dave coming at you. So you guys know I got this pallet racking, and to solve the issue of the lip, this mischievous lip, what I did was I went and bought these things. These are dowel rods from, I got them from a home improvement store, and they're 3/8 inch thick. But anyways, they're about 3 feet long. So what I did was I cut them down into various sizes. I didn't really measure them. I just kind of gave myself an assortment. And now I turned 8 into 48. So what I'll do is I'll place one of these and probably glue them like that. And then probably put one on a side, maybe two on the sides, and then across the back. And that should lift this wood, so it'll sit probably like that. But the bottoms of these comic boxes, because you know they have that little, you see it? They have that thing right here. It's like a little bit of a give. But anyways, they catch on this, so that should make it so it slides on and off real nice. So we'll go ahead and work on that, and we'll check out the finished product momentarily. DCBS.
You gotta do the dance move when you sing that. Okay.
Alright, let's see what we got going on here. So, I got my DCBS order in.
I'm gonna try to sit down without squishing the
Our cat. Friend. Oh, God, I don't even know. What are we calling you today?
You ran out of names.
Hold on, I know. I made a list.
Shall we? Which one haven't we used yet?
How do we use glutamine?
I don't think we did.
All right, today you're glutamine.
Okay, glutamine.
So our friend glutamine's joining us to help me unbox my DCBS order for August of 2019. Because nothing is more fun than waking up on Christmas morning, running downstairs, seeing all the packages under the tree. We're watching everybody open a package except for you. It's kind of the equivalent of that. This isn't going to be as fun for you as it is for me. I'll give you the box when I'm done. How about that?
Gee, thanks.
You know what? They throw extra boards in here all the time, too. Trusty Gerber down, by the way. So I'll give you a board. How about that?
Oh, okay. Sounds like a fair deal.
So, as usual, they packed it with the pretty good. It looks like
they pack it pretty nice, I think.
So there's the self forming foam, and it's in a plastic bag and all that jazz. And it's in there pretty tight. Now I think this might be the one where I didn't order any bags and boards because I was like, I'm overflowing on my lights. And plus my orders were so big, and I was like, you know what, I could calm down on this a little bit. So it doesn't look like there's as much here, but it's because there's not bags and boards taking up all that room.
There's
this is for you.
Oh, I ordered that for you. You shouldn't have.
I really shouldn't have, huh?
You shouldn't have.
So, ooh, that's cool. So we can see already, yeah, there's a House of Secrets facsimile. Can you say that? Facsimile.
Facsimile.
It's fun to say. Suffering fucking facsimile. Fun to say. All right. So. Uh-oh.
Oh, no. Don't let the tape get
Guess what? I think it did. But you know what? Oh, look at that. It's on that extra board. Oh. That's good. Thank Jeebus. Thank you, Mr. Jesus. Okay. Let's start with this. We got a Powers of X issue 3. It's a variant. I don't know. It almost looks like the Corps d'Owls from Batman. Boom.
Okay.
Let's do this. Because we want this suspense to build. Let me borrow your board. I'm going to stick the board in here to give it a little support. It's basically the bra of the...
I see.
Okay. So, Powers of X been getting all kinds of good reviews. I haven't read an issue because I haven't read anything. Son of a bitch.
There's been no time.
No time.
Literally, no time.
Vampirella number 2, the Kevin... I think it's Kevin... Stanley Art Germ Lau, I think that's what it is.
Oh.
It's Art Germ. Is that Art Germ? Does that look like Art Germ? Yeah.
It looks like.
All right, it's Art Germ. Art Germ. Dude, you know, all these Vampirella covers are tight as shit,
yeah,
man.
There was the one where, there was another variant, too. What was it? It was probably, like a one in...
Yeah, it was a ratio incentive variant.
Yeah.
There was, which one?
I don't know. I remember the one shop owner talking about the one variant where it looked like... it was different than this one, but because it looked like it was actual blood dripping down or something like that. I know
the J. Scott Campbell variant was really cool, the ratio variant. There was a black and white one that was really badass. And then there's also, there was a cosplay looking one. It was a painted picture, and I'm pretty sure it was the girl from Bat in the Sun Productions, the girl that plays... the different female characters. She's actually pretty good, but I think she might be...
Yeah,
she Armenian or something? I don't know.
I remember seeing that. We did see that one, and it looked like...
It was really nice.
Yeah. It looked like they just took a picture.
Faithless! Ooh. Number 5, the Naughty Naughty
That's
cover.
That's the naughty one.
Heaven is a place where nothing ever happens. The Talking Heads. Quote the Talking Heads. But yeah, this is the Naughty Naughty cover. Mm-hmm. There's plastic on there for a reason. And then we got another facsimile. Say it.
Facsimile.
Of Batman and Robin, issue 232, the first appearance of Ra's or Ra's al Ghul, whatever you want to call it. I actually have the original, but this is fun. And even, the facsimiles have the old ads on them too. Mm. They're cool. So got one of those. Absolute Carnage versus Deadpool.
Yay.
Number 1. I think these are all one shots. I'm not sure.
I got that one, but it was the one. Mine's different. There's been a couple different variants.
There's a shit ton of different variants. Powers of X. Number 2. This is the new character variant. This is like the new Nightcrawler like guy or whatever. I don't know.
Okay.
So he's like red instead of blue.
Yeah, he does kind of.
Yeah.
Look similar there.
Which I don't understand because Nightcrawler was blue because part of one of his powers was that his fur blended in. It was like camouflage. I think everybody forgot about that. Back in the day, one of his powers was he kind of camouflaged into the shadows and stuff. But I guess we don't do that anymore.
Yeah, you can't really do that if you're bright red. Just saying.
The hell kind of room are you in if you're in a bright red? I'm in the red room. All right, so Absolute Carnage, Separation Anxiety, number 1. This is a Young... Is this a Young Guns variant? I don't know. It's not a Young Guns. Mm-hmm. But it's definitely a variant. It's a character variant. Different symbiotes there. So that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
What else we got? Oh, that's it.
That's not it. I don't believe it.
Speaking of Art Germ, the Absolute Carnage Art Germ variant.
Yes.
So that's number 1. And I hear this Art Germ, this Art Germ series, Art Germ Carnage, that the Absolute Carnage is actually really, 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 really good.
Really?
I'm excited to get it, but I'm still behind. I still got to finish reading from my Venoms from in War of the Realms up to now. That's how far I'm behind.
I haven't read any of it, so.
You're gonna get your shit together. All right. Deceased number 4,
ooh,
the cardstock. This is the movie poster variant. I think this is Final Destination poster is what it is. Doesn't that look like it?
It kind of does look like it, now that you say that.
I said it. And then I also got the Deceased number 4 cardstock. This is the Matina Joker, and that's tight as hell.
I like that one.
Okay, boggy. I actually have a copy of that already. I got it at my comic shop as well. So for some reason, I bought 3 sets of each. Because I like the movie covers and then I like the Matinas, and I was like, you know what? It's all or nothing. House of X issue 2 says it's a variant. I don't know. I know a lot of these variants from DCBS, you kind of got to order blind because, no, yeah, the solicitations don't always have pictures in it. Like, they usually have the A cover, and then the variants usually don't, which kind of sucks in a way because I wish they'd get their shit together so that it would affect my ordering. You know what I mean? It would significantly affect my order.
Maybe there's, you know, I mean, I don't know that. Have you ever been disappointed by anyone that
Not gotten or had to hunt down covers that I wish I would have pre-ordered through DCBS because I didn't know what it was when I ordered. And that's kind of a pain in the ass. But Savage Avengers number 4. I believe this is... What is this?
Oh.
Is this the B cover? You know what?
I don't know.
I think that I have... I know what we could do. Let's do this. Let's look at the packing
list.
Who's
on there? Is that Wolverine and Conan?
How wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're savage.
Hell yeah.
Okay, so we got the packing list here. Okay. Savage Avenger, it's the Bob G variant.
Okay, it's a Bob G variant.
Yeah, Bob G.
That's pretty cool.
And then we have Symbiote Spider-Man number 5. So I think it was a 5-issue miniseries, so that's 5 of 5.
Okay.
And that was a tale from the past about when Peter Parker had the black costume before it was Venom. Then I got the character, or the Young Guns character variant of Scream number 1, Absolute Carnage Scream number 1.
That's
kind of neat. Do you like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's kind of cool. I think she might have been the first female symbiote. Why is this happening? Hey, trusty Gerber dime.
Uh-huh.
Thing ring, do your thing. Do you remember that? There was a Fantastic Four thing cartoon back in the day. Yeah, this is like early 80s, and it had really nothing to do with Fantastic Four, or really the Thing mythology. But anyways, a little kid would turn into the Thing. He had a ring.
Yeah.
And he would say, Thing ring, do your thing. And then he would turn into the Thing, and then it was clobbering time, and then, I don't know, they probably had a public service announcement, and then...
Probably, yeah.
Because knowing's half the battle. So... Absolute Carnage, number 1. The A cover. I'll tell you what. You know what? The 1 in 25, 1 in 50 of
yes.
this, the ones that were like half colored,
yes.
those were cool, man.
Those were really cool.
I'm just on the fence because I'm like, you know, how many copies of this goddamn comic do I
need?
Yeah,
really?
Because I did order the Comic Exposure exclusive plus these.
Oh, my
and,
God. I would think that would be probably...
And the Venom, the... Codex Virgin variant because it was so badass and it's Venom, so I think I ordered it on break because I was just like, I need something to order, I needed to fix.
You were having withdrawal.
I was. I think this might be Bob G as well, I'm not sure, but this is Venom.
Ooh.
17, the let's look one here. Oh no, Sung-Han Yoon, yeah, Bob G, this is Bob G, so that's a badass cover, huh?
Yeah, it is.
Venom fighting Carnage, who'd have thunk it?
Who'd have thought?
Then, the Red Sonja and Vampirella meet Betty and Veronica. The Robert Hack cover. This is number 4.
Okay.
Looks like an old VHS tape, right?
Yes, it does.
Yeah, it looks like your old Faces of Death videotape. Oh, like you never watched Faces of Death. Shut up. Oh, here's another copy I ordered. Oh, no, this is Marvel Comics 1000. This is the Del Auto.
I was gonna say, who's on there? Daredevil.
Daredevil. Everybody's favorite handicapped hero, handicapable hero. I'm a big Daredevil fan.
Mm-hmm.
This is the, I don't know if it's a, I don't think it's a 1 in 10 or anything like that.
It's cool though. It's a nice cover.
It's absolutely lovely. Let's see if it says on here. I don't even see it on there. Maybe it's on there.
No.
Unless it's way up top there.
Yes.
Nope.
No.
See, Marvel Comics 1000. Why, I don't see it. Oh, right here. It must be just a $9.99. Del Auto variant. Yeah, it's Del Auto variant. So, then we have House of X, number 3. Guess what? Variant edition.
That's very colorful.
It's very colorful. Has all the characters crammed on it.
Yes.
Let's see here.
Did they leave anyone out? Hopefully they got
every
them off.
Single
every single one. I think they tried to get on there.
It says Azrar connecting variant. So I guess
so
if you got the different X titles
one,
and put them all together. Yeah.
Okay.
Absolute Carnage, Lethal Protectors number one. This is a variant as well. Oh. I think I ordered this blind as well. It has Misty Knight, Morbius, and Iron Fist on there.
Cool.
Sweet.
Yes.
And I had to order the A cover of Marvel Comics 1000 because usually the A cover is the one that's the most sought after. And it is. It's Alex Ross. It's badass. So we did that.
Okay.
So with the discounts and stuff, you know, with DCBS usually pay like 40% to 50%.
Yeah.
So Absolute Carnage number two.
Cool.
Boy, I know you were looking all over the place for that some bitch.
Was.
You didn't get yours, huh? I did finally get it,
yes.
Absolute Carnage, Miles Morales, number one. And this is the variant cover. I think that's the B cover. I believe it's the B cover. No, this is the A cover. So, cool.
Mm-hmm.
So many tie-ins for Absolute Carnage.
Yeah, I was say, oh my God.
Batman, Superman, number one. This is the Batman cover. It's a connecting
Batman,
cover.
Batman. Oh, that's the connecting Batman.
Yeah.
The last one.
So the other side has Batman with...
Yes.
Or Superman with Batman. Superman in the foreground and Batman on the background. And then I got two copies of this. This is the reprint of ASM 300,
mm-hmm.
but it's called... Amazing Spider-Man Venom number one. It's in 3D. See, what comes with the 3D glasses.
Mm-hmm.
What I'll probably end up doing, so it doesn't leave an imprint on the on the comic, is I'll open these up, or at least open one up,
mm-hmm.
and put the glasses in a bag and board behind it.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
I would think that would leave an imprint or something in the book.
I was thinking about sending one of these out for CGC just because it'd be fun, right?
Yeah.
I'd like to get all the Hulk 181 and ASM 300 different
it would be because it would be different since how it's the 3D one.
Well, even like the True Believers and stuff, like I think it would be cool just to have like all the different, like as a CGC collection, having all the different I consider it's like a variant of the different first appearances of like Venom and Wolverine. I don't know, just something I was thinking about. I think too much. Did I order two of these?
Oh, you must have, huh?
I don't remember ordering two of these, but I guess I did. Batman Superman number one. House of Secrets 92. Facsimile. You know, this book is so expensive and so hard to come by. So this is actually a really good one to have a facsimile of. I know years ago, it wasn't so much, and probably about, I want to say it was more than 10 years ago. About 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. I went to a con and I was like, today's the day I'm buying the House of Secrets 92.
Yeah.
And, I walked up to a guy and I'm like, you got a House of Secrets 92? He's like, yeah. He's like, that book just shot up. I'm like, what? It was never really expensive. And then all of a sudden it just skyrocketed. Mm-hmm. And then it was kind of like the first appearance of Moon Knight. Like all of a sudden everybody was scooping him up and not for any reason.
So that probably might have put it out of reach.
Huh? Yeah, it definitely was. So I've never got, I would assume eventually someday I'll get it, but for now this will hold the fort.
That'll be okay until you can actually get.
So, questions, comments, suggestions on the DCBS order for August? No.
No, there's a lot of cool covers.
Yeah, like, absolutely. Yeah. You know what's cool? Check this out. Instead of saying 300, it says 3D on there.
Oh,
isn't that cool? Instead of saying a 300 on the background.
3D.
Uh-huh. Ain't that something?
They think of everything.
All right.
I think that they think of everything.
Well, that's it for the DCBS order for August of 2019. I would like to say thank you to, what was your name today?
Glutamine.
But let's face it, I did all the heavy lifting here.
I was here for support. Yes.
Okay. So I'm here with our friend Green Bean.
I like green beans. Do you all like green beans?
And we're going to be doing one of our hauls that we haven't got to yet. You know, we had all these sell hauls, and we keep getting more and more.
Yeah, it's just been a little overwhelming. There hasn't been a lot of time lately.
Moderately whelming.
Yeah, moderately.
But if you guys remember, I did a video on my dime self from one of the stores, and you didn't do it. So go ahead and start with the dime stuff, okay, and then we'll move on.
Because
we went back for another sale after that.
Yes, I did not get that many, but I did get Marvel Comics Deadpool 66.
It's a rhino.
Mm-hmm. I got a few Doom Patrol. So this is the Doom Patrol number 3.
That looks like a 2000s one, maybe.
Yeah.
And then you got some for your 80s.
And then I got, number 4.
Cool.
And number 2.
Did you make a number 2 or did you? Oh.
No.
Two number 2s. I made two number 2s. Oh, okay. Go ahead.
Just Doom Patrol number 2.
Seemed like a fool's errand. Okay.
And also Doom Patrol number 2, but this is a different
series. Different volume.
Yes.
Speaking of volume, that covers up to 11. Boom. Wow.
Yes.
Pow. Cool.
And this is a special Doom Patrol and Suicide Squad number 1.
Cool. Seemed pretty special.
Uh-huh. And this is, what is this, number 10.
Number 10.
Metallo has trashed the Doom Patrol.
It's got soups in it.
It's got Superman in it there, yeah.
You know who Metallo is, right?
No. Why don't you tell us who...
I can tell you who it is. So Metallo is a Superman villain, but he's kind of like a cyborg, but his mind's still in the cyborg. But he's powered by kryptonite. He has a kryptonite heart, so...
Oh, okay.
From the radiation, so it makes him a good villain for Superman, because all he has to do is... Yeah. All right, so anyway, so that was your dime store haul?
That was what I got for a dime.
Okay.
Okay, and then...
So that was like a dollar right there.
Yeah, well, I mean, really. Maybe.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. I got some of my Doom Patrol.
You know what I got at that sale that I didn't show?
What's that?
So they had on that table.
They had some toys and stuff. I did not bring that. I got
But I went out there and I was like, I wonder if they have. So wait, I've been looking for one of these for years. And they did have it. They had Smurf figurines and they had a hefty Smurf, the weightlifting Smurf. I needed it.
You needed it.
Do you know how hard it is to find a weightlifting hefty Smurf?
I honestly don't.
But they were what?
They were
50 cents a piece for a buck or something like that? I don't know.
I got some little cars for my nephew. Mm-hmm. I got a couple cars for him. And
for her nephew.
It is.
Yeah, meanwhile you're at home going
yeah, well.
Vroom.
You know what?
And then doing the Dukes of Hazzard. Yeah.
Yes, they're for my nephew.
And then I got a... I thought this would be good for Christmas decoration
or
something.
Yes, it is.
So I got... I don't know what his name is. Big Package Smurf. We'll call him.
Okay.
Large Package Smurf.
Large Package Smurf.
Smurfy.
My, that's a big box.
That's a big package you got there. Where are you going to put it? Wrapped it up with a bow.
Mm-hmm.
And then this one I just grabbed because he was like nerdy. He's a nerdy Smurf. I don't know what his name is. But he also has nose picking action. So, boom.
So that was
my dollar. Dollar bill, yo! All right.
Okay.
So, is it my turn?
Yeah, because we went back.
We went back for another sale.
Because they had 20% off sale.
Okay.
So we went back and got a couple more.
Yeah, so everything that we bought was 20% off.
Mm-hmm.
So I found these in the back issue bins. They look like they're nicer than the copies I had. I wasn't sure. But I grabbed them because they were like $2 or something. So Uncanny X-Men 165. I know this one's nicer than my copy. This is such a badass cover.
That's pretty,
162. Yeah, it's very purpley.
That looks really nice.
Dude, that was when X-Men was on point, man. That was when they were in space, and it was just awesome. That's my X-Men right there. I grabbed this. I think it's this. This one might actually have been a quarter or something.
Oh, yeah, I like that.
This is the X-Force. Yes. I just like because the Saturday Evening Post. Mm-hmm. Then I think these were a buck a piece. Marvel Tales 207. Why did I buy that, Green Bean? Because it's one of the ones that have the spider pig, the original spider pig tales. It's not just a reprint. It has an original spider pig story in there. Then I came across this. I think this was a buck. It's the Defenders number 68. Whitman! See it?
Oh, I can knock that.
Oh, no. Well, I killed his big... His big package is always in the way. And then, does it stick? I wonder if you can make it stick to his leg. All right. So, anyways, I don't have this issue for my Batman collection anyways, but this is really cool. It is Batman number 311, but it's the Whitman variant. Dr. Phosphorus. Yeah. That's the good old days. Mm-hmm. And then I found this. I think this was $5. This was the first one I paid, like, any money for. Bought 20% off, so yeah. $4. First appearance of the Puma. That's ASM 256. It's a really nice copy of that. And then one of these. I haven't got one of these yet, and I've been wanting it. It is the first appearance of Scarlet Spider. It's Web of Spider-Man number 118. It's a super nice copy, except for there's a little fold on the back cover in a corner, which I don't know if it can be pressed out or not.
I was going to say, might be able to be pressed out.
But regardless, I got that for... Actually, I think I paid $20 for it, but I don't have one of those, and I'm happy to have it now. And actually, it spiked. Remember, I bought it, and then we watched the top 10, and it was spiking that week, so I really lucked out on that. Yep. So that was good, perfect timing.
Yep.
Okay, so that's that.
Okay, so I got, I found a Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, number 5. Amazing Spider-Man 274.
I really like that story. I think I told you to buy it just to read it because it's really good.
And this one, I think this one was $8, but it was 20% off. So, you know, and it looks really, really nice. But it's Amazing Spider-Man, number 220. And he actually brought it over to me because he you know, you had told him about me wanting to get that I was collecting the Moon Knights. And it was a really nice copy, so... also picked up Amazing Spider-Man number 280.
That's that original cover. They just did that homage with the new female Sinister Six.
And I got Jughead the Hunger number 6. Number 7. And number 8.
Those are good ones.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's what I got there.
Cool. So while we were in the area... We decided that we knew there's another comic shop there. It has a really good dollar bin usually, and it always, especially the spider books.
Yeah.
It seems there's always good spider books in the dollar bin for some reason. Mm-hmm. So we hit that up.
Yes.
And let's see what we got there. Actually, you found this one for me. It was a Boys I Think I'm Missing, and it's number 35.
Okay.
And I don't know what's going on down there. Can you see that? and then I found a Batman Chronicles number 4, which I already have, but I do not have the DC Universe logo of that.
I like the coloring.
Yeah, it's cool, man. This was Contagion. This was before...
The border, and then just the coloring. I don't know what it is. It's just... Yeah.
This was... they did Contagion, then they did... what was it called? It was an earthquake. Then they did No Man's Land. This was sort of elitist. But I've never seen the DCU logo red before. Yeah. Then I found this. It's Marvel Ultimate Spider-Man number 19. Uh-huh. So it's basically from the animated series, but it's a Venom cover. So that's why I grabbed it, because I like the Venom cover. And you found this one too.
Yeah.
This is actually, this is actually not called fake news. This is Trump Titans number 1. This is the first appearance of Trump Titans. But it's the retailer incentive cover. When I looked it up, it's the retailer incentive. So it's probably like a 1 in 10 or 1 per store or something like that. Then, let's see, I found 2 Timely Comic logo Totally Awesome Hulk number 1. So this is the first appearance of Amadeus Cho as a Hulk, or I think he goes by Braun now. But it's the variant, because it has a Timely Comic. But it's also the first appearance of Lady Hellbender, who was in the Venom annual here recently. And you know, Venom Annual number one. Not Venom Annual number one, but Venom Annual number one.
Venom Annual number one.
Because they, for some reason, this series has two Venom Annual number ones. I don't understand.
Very confusing, but yes, there's two number ones.
Also, for a buck, we just saw this on the top 10, and it's Spider-Man 2. It's the first appearance of the evil.
His package
is just flopping around all over the place. So, it's the first appearance of the evil Miles Morales. So I think those were all for a buck, right? They were all a buck.
Yeah, I think they were pretty much all a dollar.
Okay.
So I got like five or six of the Minob. But I found, what is number is this? Number five. Wraith, number five.
That's the Christmas land.
Yeah, it's the Christmas land one. And then
you actually threw one of those at me. Just in case.
Yes.
Ooh.
I found a Spawn 262.
That's a good one.
I didn't have it. I also found a Godzilla.
Gojira!
Number five. And I got it because of the drawing. It's Dave Wachter.
Okay, cool.
Also, Civil War, it's the Mini Mates. It's a variant edition. Civil War number one. But they're all... Lego. They're all little Lego.
Yeah, that's what the Mini Mates are.
Yeah, they're like, it's cute. It's cute. And you also threw one of these at me too.
A Spider-Man number two.
But those
evil.
Those were all a dollar.
Miles Morales. They're all a buck a piece.
Yeah. Didn't go crazy.
It's a buck.
You know, didn't go crazy. Didn't get that many, but
yeah.
You know,
spent $5 or $10 and got a lot of cool shit.
Got a lot of cool books, I think.
Yeah. For the price of what, one or two books, you got all those. Cool. All right. Well, is that it for our hauls for that day?
Yeah, I think so.
Cool. All right. Well, that's probably it. So we'll guess we'll nerdcore out. Nerdcore out.
Yeah.
Get a good look at this package.
If I had the power to gather all of my favorite MCs with the illest comic book characters, and they became arch enemies. Inconceivable, unbelievable, yet as wild as it seems. The Emperor and Stan Lee would coach the two opposing teams. Keep it clean.
All right. The first rule about Nerdcore is don't talk about Nerdcore. All right. Check it out, guys. So I went ahead and used some liquid nails. Boom. It's the perfect glue. Fuse it. So I took those dowels. And I put one there. Yeah, the leg's not the greatest, but you can see that I slapped them like that. And you can see how significant that lip is before that board. So that's how much it's gonna raise it up. If you can see that. So, all that's left to do now is to slip this sumbitch in place without knocking those over. Should fall right in. There we go. Look at that. No, they didn't fall down. And that weight on there should keep it flush until that glue dries. That's how much of a lip. In a comic box, it should slide right on. Let's try one. We got one right here. Look at that. So now these things won't get hooked like that anymore. Cool, right? Now we're jiggy with it. All right, guys.